Any other question? All right. So last week we finished with chapter 16. Just to remind you what chapter 16 ended on, that was Le Chatelier. I don't know. French. I don't know how to spell that. Le Chatelier. So basically, Le Chatelier is if you're in equilibrium and you do something to put yourself out of equilibrium, the reaction will respond to put itself back into equilibrium. So for a generic reaction of reactants go to products, if you add more reactants, the system will respond by adding products. If you take away reactants, the system will respond by making reactants. And then we had gases and we had reactions that were endothermic and exothermic. What we are going to start now is chapter 17. And chapter 17 is all about acids and bases. This is something that we cover in Gen Chem 1. But we're going to go into it more in depth here. And we're going to start with definitions of what an acid and a base is. And we actually have two different definitions. One's called the Arrhenius definition, and the other set is called the Bronsted-Lowry. And these two definitions differ by the Arrhenius is what do you make in water? While the Bronsted-Lowry is more concerned about what you do with hydrogens. So Arrhenius, when I put you in water, what do you make? Bronsted-Lowry is in a chemical reaction, how do you treat hydrogens? So let's start with our acid. We're going to define acids using both systems. So for our acids, the Arrhenius definition states you make H plus when you're put into water. And in reality, you would make what's called hydronium, H3O plus. However, in writing chemistry, a lot of times people will just say H plus as a way to shorthand hydronium. But yeah, that H3O plus is called hydronium. So very simply, if I have HA, and by the way, I'm going to be using this terminology quite a bit here and there. HA is generic acid. This A stands for your anion, right? So anytime I write HA, I'm just saying generic acid, all acids behave. So generic acid, when you put it into water, makes H plus and A minus. While the Bronsted-Lowry definition of acids say you are a hydrogen donor. So in a reaction, you give away your hydrogen. And so let's write this generic reaction with water. HA plus H2O. So what that acid is going to do is that it's going to give that hydrogen to that H2O. And so you're going to make A minus plus H3O plus.
So you can see both definitions are actually saying the same thing. You have the same reaction going on. It's just, what are you looking at? Are you looking at what you make, or are you looking at what you're doing with hydrogen? Now, let's do the same thing, but with bases. But before we do that, any questions about our definitions of acids here? All right. So let's do the same thing with base. So for a base in the Arrhenius definition, again, this is what you make when you're put in water, you make OH minus, which is called hydroxide. So if I just take a base, like for example, sodium hydroxide, and I put that in water, you get OH minus. And then the Bronsted-Lowry definition is you are a hydrogen acceptor. Right? Acids were hydrogen donors. Bases are hydrogen acceptors. So if I do this reaction with sodium hydroxide again, and I have water, right? So this base is going to accept a hydrogen from water. So it takes that hydrogen from water, and what you make is sodium plus water plus OH minus. So again, these definitions are saying the same thing. It's just, what are you looking at? What are you concerned about? That's what is different between these two types of definitions. Questions about our base definition. All right. So the last thing we are gonna kind of define is a neutralization reaction. So neutralization. And that's when you mix an acid plus a base. And when you mix an acid and a base, you always get the same thing. You get a salt plus H2O. And they call it neutralization because since you're making water and some salt, the pH is usually around 7. You're going back to neutral pH conditions. However, in this chapter, we're going to learn about what happens when you don't go back to neutral pH of 7, because there are a lot of situations where that happens. But let's just give an example reaction here. Hydrochloric acid plus sodium hydroxide. So remember, an acid donates a hydrogen. A base accepts a hydrogen. And you make Na plus Cl minus. That's our salt plus H2O. So there is our neutralization reaction. The last thing I want to touch on is a question I get all the time. How do you know if you have an acid or a base? Right, so chemically, just looking at a formula, how am I able to tell so easily whether I'm dealing with an acid or a base? There are some tricks. So let's talk about the acids. A lot of the times when you write an acid, you will have the hydrogen as your first element. Right? HCl is telling you that you have a hydrogen, or rather has a hydrogen in front. That's saying it's acidic. So that's one way. Another way we might be able to tell if we have an acid is if it's positively charged. So if it's positively charged and has hydrogens, for example, NH4 plus. So there's no hydrogen in front, but it's positively charged with a bunch of hydrogen. So that's another way I can tell if it's an acid. And another common way is that if you have an oxygen bound to a hydrogen, but this one we need to be careful about because it's actually a base too, but we'll kind of talk about the cases where it's a base. For example, what do I want to do there? What's a good acid? There's a lot of acids with OHs on it. And I'm trying to think of a good example off the top of my head. So like COOH. When you see that group, that's 100% an acid. So I'm looking at an oxygen and a hydrogen together. How do I know if I'm working with a base just by looking at it? So a lot of the bases we use in general chemistry are going to have the same form. You're going to have a metal plus OH. So sodium hydroxide, calcium hydroxide. So that's why I said be careful when I said acids have OHs. Bases do too, but if it's with a metal, that's telling you that's a base. You will not have an acid that looks like metal plus OH. Bases can also be negatively charged, but they don't have to be. I'm really kind of try to focus on knowing what's an acid. And then when we get into conjugate pairs, which is like what we're going to next, then we'll kind of get more comfortable hopefully looking at these molecules and knowing what's an acid versus a base. So that was our 15 minutes of vocabulary, because this is also part of a language class, learning the language of chemistry. Any questions about any of this terminology before we do some problems here? Yeah. Yeah, but not with a metal attached, otherwise that would be a base. Maybe. It's going to be more likely an acid than a base, but it doesn't have to be an acid. So it gets a little tricky. That's why it's you understand it more the more you do it. But these are like some guidelines to help you along. And then the more you get familiar with it, the more you understand the outlier cases. But this is good, like basic ground rules, beginner level. I follow these until I get more comfortable with the nuances kind of thing. Any other questions about our definitions? notes. So our first question of the day is question 72. Question 72 is simply state whether this is an acid or base. That's your first goal. Just say, is the molecule an acid or a base? Then write a chemical reaction with it interacting with water. All right, so first off, are you looking at acid or base? Once you decide that, show me what how it reacts. I'll do the first one for you so you know kind of what I'm looking for. So our first molecule is HNO3. From the guidelines we just went over, I said if the hydrogen is in front, that's most likely going to be an acid. And HNO3 is an acid. So I write water as my other reactant. From our definitions, we said acids are hydrogen donors. So I'm going to donate my hydrogen to the water, and you make NO3 minus plus H3O plus. The way I'm getting these charges is that hydrogen has a plus one charge. So if HNO3 loses a hydrogen, it now becomes negative one. If H2O gains a hydrogen, it's now plus one, because each hydrogen is plus one. So I'm just trading them. So that's what I would like you to do for the following scenarios. So B is NH4 plus. C is KOH. D is HC2H3O2. And then E is SROH2. Right? So take a couple of minutes. Now I'm just going to add plus water here for each of these. But tell me if we're dealing with an acid or a base. Once you decide that, show me the chemical reaction, please. If you have questions, let me know. Thank you.
Hydrogen as first element. Right now, the charge is zero. Hydrogen is up like a dollar. So if I cast one extra dollar, that's positive. So I get my dollars H2O. So I don't have any dollars left. I get an extra dollar. I get a positive charge.
Oh, it's wrong.
Yeah, and like if I'm neutral and I lose a dollar, that's just one beat. That's zero. That's one. That's zero. That's one. That's zero. That's one. That's all that's happening with the charge.
It's just a tongue.
It's dropped.
Yeah. So
like
even
it dropped.
So say it was. You can say it's possible.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So
it's
a problem. All right. All righty. Let's take a look.
What's up? Some are, some aren't. We'll get into that. Not every reaction here is reversible. If I was gonna do this, not reversible. I think that one is. That one's not. That one is. That one's not. But we'll talk about why that is. All right. So B, you have a positive charge with a bunch of hydrogens. That's telling you you're dealing with an acid. An acid donates a hydrogen, so you become NH3 neutral, no charge. Remember, a hydrogen has a plus one charge. So if I'm already plus one and I lose a positive charge, I become zero. And water's accepting that, so you become H3O plus, you become hydronium. C, you have a metal plus OH, so that is a base. You are a hydrogen acceptor, so you're accepting that hydrogen from water. What you make is K plus. The metal always falls off. You are remaking water, and then you have hydroxide left over, OH minus, right? So it's the water that is becoming hydroxide here, right? The water loses its hydrogen, become OH minus. D, your first element is hydrogen. That's telling you right away, okay, that's an acid. An acid donates a hydrogen to water, and you become C2H3O2 minus plus H3O plus. Again, our acid was neutral to begin with, and so if you lose a hydrogen, you become minus one. Question there. Can you repeat why NH4 plus becomes neutral? Yeah, so NH4 plus, let me just do that over at the side. NH4 plus currently has a plus one charge, right? So if I'm kind of doing a score sheet of the charges, each hydrogen is plus one. So you have four hydrogens, each of these is plus one, and you have nitrogen. Nitrogen is minus three. How do I know it's minus three? Well, when I add all these elements together, I must get plus one, and I know hydrogen's always plus one. So when I add all these elements together, my overall score is plus one. Now I become NH3. Well, hydrogen, like I said, has a plus one charge. Nitrogen still has this minus three charge. Now I'm zero. Basically, anytime you remove a hydrogen, your charge goes down by one level, right? So if I was plus one, I get demoted to zero. Anytime you gain a hydrogen, you get promoted a charge. So if you're zero, you go to plus one. If you were negative one, you go to zero. It's bookkeeping, really. You're bookkeeping your current charge. You just know hydrogens are always plus one. So that's what you got to keep in mind. All right, our last one, SROH2. SR is a metal, OH is a base. This is currently unbalanced, so I need two waters here, because each water is going to give a hydrogen to a hydroxide. You're going to make SR2 plus two molecules of water plus two hydroxides. One other question you might have is, how do I know strontium is 2+? Hydroxide always has a charge of minus one. And if I have two hydroxides, together they make a charge of minus two. And if I pair it with strontium, and I say this charge is neutral, strontium must be plus two. So the math I'm doing is that each OH is minus one. When paired with strontium, it must be plus two, because when I add everything together, it becomes zero. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yep, because each OH takes a hydrogen, so I need two water molecules to do that. Each water can only give one hydrogen. Water cannot give both of its hydrogens away. Mm-hmm. Any other questions about our definitions of acids and bases? Yeah. If you knew about it, great, but this is why we do this problem, so I can tell you about it. Learning by doing. I figured most of you would make that mistake, and what better way to learn than to make a mistake and then immediately be told that's actually not how you do it. But if you knew how to do it, that's awesome. But if you didn't, that's fine. I'm showing you right now. Only lose one hydrogen at a time from water, so you need multiple waters. Oh, you might have problems where you have multiple hydroxides, yes. So whenever you're, do you remember what AQ means? What does that mean? It's in water. So yes, there's more than one. All acid and base chemistry is done pretty much in water. Assume you have limitless supply of water. Yep. All right. Any other questions about acid or base chemistry? All good back there? So basically, yeah, I'll just reiterate. If you have multiple OHs, let's say it's OH3, you need three water molecules to interact with that. However, I might be tricky and say, give you a reaction where I only put one copy of water, because I'm testing you to see if you understand that concept. So if I do metal OH3, now that I have more space, plus H2O, you have to balance that correctly and say, no, actually you need three water molecules. That's all that's going on. All right, let's move on to more vocab. The next thing we're gonna talk about is conjugates. So I'm gonna write down my generic reaction of an acid. So HA plus H2O makes A minus plus H3O plus. So in this reaction, my hydrogen gives a hydrogen to water, right? So this would be my acid because it's donating a hydrogen. And the water is my base because it accepted a hydrogen. Now, this definition is if you read the equation left to right. However, since we have a double arrow, this means this reaction is reversible. So let's read this reaction right to left. If I read it from right to left, what's happening is that H3O plus is giving a hydrogen to A minus to form HA and H2O plus. So reading this reaction from right to left, I would say that H3O plus is my acid, A minus is my base. However, we have special words for this. We would say that A minus is my conjugate base. H3O plus is my conjugate acid, right? So the word conjugate base and conjugate acid basically means if I read this reaction reverse, which would be my acid and what would be my base? And another way to think about this is that in this reaction, HA becomes A minus. So my acid becomes my conjugate base. And H2O, which was my base, became H3O plus, which is my conjugate acid. And when you group them together, like I just did, what I have written down, we call conjugate pairs. So a conjugate pair is an acid with its conjugate base when they're together, or a base with its conjugate acid. An acid will always make a conjugate base. A base will always make a conjugate acid. This is what you make in a reaction. That's the terminology. Conjugate pairs, the only difference is one hydrogen. So if I just give you two molecules and I ask you, are these conjugate pairs? All you need to do is see if these molecules differ by one hydrogen. Or by conjugate acid, and my acid and my conjugate base rather, right? They only differ by a hydrogen when I'm looking at the molecules themselves. For my base, they differ by a hydrogen. OH minus, just to give you an example, and H3O plus, not conjugate. They differ by more than one hydrogen, right? So for conjugates, you can only have a one hydrogen difference. So that's our next term, conjugates and conjugate pairs. So I'm gonna throw some equations at you and I'm gonna ask you, well, let me write down our question here. But before we do that, any question about our definition of conjugates here, or conjugate pairs, conjugate acid and conjugate base? All right. So question 73. For the following, I want you to identify, ID the following, please. The acid, the base, the conjugate acid, and the conjugate base. So I'm going to give you some equations, and all you need to do is label them. Which one's the acid? Which one's the base? Which one's the conjugate acid? Which one's the conjugate base? So our first reaction is this. Plus H2O. There's reaction one, reaction two, reaction 3. HNO3 plus H2O. H3O plus NO3 minus. There's two more, but I'm actually going to do one that's different here. Let's do let's do that. All right. For each of these, see if you can tell me what my acid and my base, my conjugate acid and conjugate base are. Give you a few minutes to do these problems. Like I said, there's two more examples on 73, but I think this will give us enough information to understand what's going on.
No, so I guarantee you we're all conjugates here. I just want to tell you that. Yeah. Another way to do this is to read the reaction backwards. If I read the reaction backwards, what's going to happen? There's two ways. Yeah, we just do some reps, but it's not that complicated. But that's how most things are. Like, it's not complicated once you get it. Learning about this is complicated.
Alrighty, let's break down. Problem, whatever number I wrote. So first off, we have to decide what's the acid or what's the base. There's different ways you can do it. One way you can do it, let me show you one way. Look at H2CO3 on the left side of the reaction and see what it became. It became HCO3 minus. So if I'm just looking at this molecule, I would say I lost a hydrogen. If you lose a hydrogen or donate it, you're an acid. And an acid always makes a conjugate base. H2O, if you look at what happened, H2O went to H3O plus. I gained a hydrogen during the reaction. So if I gain a hydrogen, then I'm a base. And the thing I made is called the conjugate acid. Right? So that's one way you can do it. You can just look to see what happened to the molecule on both sides of the equation. Did I lose a hydrogen or did I gain a hydrogen? Right? You can also just look at the molecules like we said. So NH3, this one's a little tricky, but we have multiple hydrogens and we're neutral, so we're most likely going to be a base. And I can determine that because I made NH4 plus. So, I did gain a hydrogen. So NH4 plus is my conjugate acid. Water loss of hydrogen become OH minus. So I gave my hydrogen over there. So I was an acid. And the thing I made is called the conjugate base. HNO3, we have a hydrogen in front. Remember, if we have that, you can be pretty sure that's an acid. And so the other molecule I'm interacting with is a base. And we can double check that. Yeah, NO3 lost its hydrogen during this reaction. Okay. So the acid became the conjugate base. The base H2O gained a hydrogen. So it became the conjugate acid. And then HCl and sodium hydroxide. So we have an acid in our base. Cl minus is our conjugate base because the acid lost a hydrogen. And this one I see a lot of people get confused on which one's your conjugate acid, Na plus or H2O. Well, that's H2O. Right. First off, to be an acid, you have to have a hydrogen. You cannot. Well, right now, you don't know that you can be an acid without a hydrogen. So just assume until I tell you otherwise, to be an acid, you need a hydrogen. But also look at this reaction in reverse. I'm making HCl. I'm making NaOH. The only way to make OH is for this water molecule to give a hydrogen to my chlorine. That's an acid.
right? Sodium is not doing anything in this reaction. It's just there. So sodium is nothing. It doesn't get a classification. All right. Questions about looking at reactions and determining acid-base, conjugate acid, conjugate base. Got one more exercise for you, because knowing this terminology is going to be helpful down the line. So problem 74 is right along the same things. So these, what I'm going to write down first, these are acids. Please write the conjugate base formula. Formula. There we go. So the acids are, we already did that one, so let's do H2SO3, HCHO2, and HF. So for, oh, that's supposed to be HSO3. So A, B, C. So for my three acids, please write the conjugate base. And then for the bases I'm going to give you, please write the conjugate acid form. Acid formula. And so we already did that one as well. So let's do ClO4 minus HSO4 minus and CO3 minus 2. All right. So for the top three in blue, write the conjugate base of those acids. For the bottom three in red, write the conjugate acid of those bases, please. This is a good way to practice if you know what conjugates are.
All right, so let's look at how to do this. So if I'm making a conjugate base from my acid, all you do is you lose one hydrogen, so H2SO3 becomes HSO3 with a minus one charge, because remember, hydrogens are plus one. HCHO2 becomes CHO2 minus. A common question I get is, does it matter which hydrogen you take? No, but yes. That's a weird answer. So no, technically it doesn't. But yes, it makes more sense if you take the first one away. It's the difference of me going, of me saying to school I go versus I'm going to school. Yeah, they're both right. One just sounds weird. Right, CHF becomes F minus. For the bases, you gain a hydrogen, so ClO4 minus becomes HClO4 neutral, because you were minus one, you gained a hydrogen, so you become zero. HSO4 becomes H2SO4 neutral. CO3 minus 2 becomes HCO3 minus 1, because you gained a hydrogen. All right, questions, last questions on writing conjugates. All right, that seems like a decent stop point, because we're going to bounce into a new section. I did just post your grades for test 2. All I had to do was hit a button, and now they're all up. So I apologize for that. They were up as of last week, but I didn't hit that button. But yeah, let's take a break until, let's go till 9:11 a.m. So get up, stretch around, have a snack. Do what you need to do. I'll see you back here in 10 minutes.
I have a question.